The idea of finding a new planet is always so appealing and exciting, but what if a rogue planet just kind of wandered into our solar system? Hey, it might have already happened. Hey guys, space fan Amy with you on D News today. Last year, astronomers at Caltech announced the discovery of a potential new planet, Planet 9. We've talked about it before. It's a hypothetical planet whose existence has been theorized by observations of distant Kuiper Belt objects. Six of these small bodies are tracing out similarly irregular orbits around the Sun, suggesting there's some big gravitational mass tugging on them. That would be Planet 9. If it exists, it's between 10 times the mass of Earth and the mass of Neptune. It orbits some 1,000 astronomical units away, so 1,000 times further from the Sun than the Earth, and it has an inclined orbit. The question then is, how could a planet that big have formed that far away from the Sun with such an odd orbit? Well, new research from a team at New Mexico State University says that it might not have formed in our solar system at all. It might have been captured. We might have taken in an orphaned interloper of a planet. We tend to think of a planet as orbiting a star, but according to a previous study out of the Osaka University in Japan, rogue planets are actually fairly common. 75% of all Jupiter-mass planets might be free-floating in space. The astronomers came to this number using a method called gravitational microlensing. This technique involves measuring how much a massive object warps the light from a distant star as seen from Earth. Usually used to find a planet orbiting a distant star, astronomers found some odd instances of microlensing in datasets. The data was consistent with a planet passing in front of a star, but there was no signal linking it to a host star. Their conclusion was that these planets are free-floating rogues, wandering alone through space. And there were a lot of them. This team found 10 in just 2 years, suggesting there are potentially twice as many rogue planets as there are planets in solar systems, and that's just in the Milky Way alone. Okay, so if this is true, remember we're in hypotheticals right now, could Planet 9 be a captured rogue? The team from New Mexico State carried out 156 simulations of solar system encounters with a rogue planet hitting our system at an inclined angle and found that yes, it's possible. In 50% of the simulations, the rogue encountered the system and was simply slingshotted out on its way. Only occasionally, just 10% of the time, did a rogue passing through rip another planet out of the system with it, creating a new rogue. But in 40% of the encounter simulations, the rogue became part of the system. There are a couple of ways this could happen. With a planet the mass of Neptune, which is about 17 times the mass of Earth, and within the range Planet 9 is thought to be, it would be a soft capture. The rogue would start orbiting the Sun without disrupting the solar system at all. If the planet was more massive, say the mass of Jupiter, which is about 318 times the mass of Earth, the rogue would make an exchange. It would enter our system but fling another planet out in its stead. An even bigger rogue, three times the mass of Jupiter, would have a more devastating effect. This rogue would be massive enough to kick two or more planets out of the system. It could even boot everyone out. Obviously, that last one didn't happen, but still, rogue planets are real, and it's possible that they shaped the solar system we know and love, and one might have even joined us on its journey. Speaking of interlopers, if NASA were to find alien interlopers, would it tell us? I dig into the history of this question over on Vintage Space, and there's more on Planet 9 right here. Do you guys love or hate the idea of Planet 9 being a captured rogue? Let us know in the comments below, be sure to like this video and subscribe so you never miss an episode of D News.